that last week we reported how in China the 3D movie Avatar was being pulled from cinemas to make way for a state-supported, big-budget biopic of the ancient Chinese philosopher Confucius. Copies of Confucius have been sent to pretty well every cinema in the country, an unprecedented distribution. But what's the film actually like? I spoke on the line from Beijing with Simon Fowler of Time Out Beijing magazine, and first of all asked him what kind of Confucius we're getting here.
I think the film is trying to show him as about 20% Machiavelli, 80% Jesus, really, because his father was a warrior. He was trained, in a similar fashion. There's a great scene of him in a sort of Robin Hood style archery shoot off. But towards the latter end of the film, when he does get a lot older, it's more about him and his followers following him around, and they keep referring to him as, you know, the teacher. And that's really is what they're trying to say, is because his philosophies were so influential on Chinese society that he was this almost godlike figure for them in a lot of ways.
Confucius's philosophy has reached outside China anyway as a series of rather wonderful little phrases and sayings. You know, an oppressive government is more to be feared than a tiger, or choose a job you love and you will never have to work a day in your life, that kind of thing. How do they deal with those in the film? Do they give us them?
Oh, yes. It's very much going for the quotable Confucius throughout. But there were a couple of times when the audience chuckled along when these big, profound statements would come out.
How does the film look?
The film is beautifully shot. The cinematographer is Peter Pau, who people will know for The Forbidden Kingdom, which was the Jackie Chan film a while back. And he also won an Oscar for his cinematography on Ang Lee's Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. I mean, what I will say against it is it looks exactly like every other sweeping historical Chinese epic of the past 20 years. And it's just these big sweeping landscapes, these huge armies, and the camera zooming, you know, above them. Plus, his previous film, The Forbidden Kingdom, it almost looks identical with all these misty mountains and beautiful, beautiful set pieces, but it's almost to the point of overexposure. I mean, for someone who's watched a lot of Chinese films, and there's also in the film a lot of subtitles that come up to be like, oh yeah, by the way, this is such and such who was important for this reason.
This information then about who people are, who these famous people are, do the Chinese viewers get it as well, or is this just in English subtitles?
No, this appears on the screen in Chinese as well, because there's so many different characters coming up at all the time. So it is to remind you, saying, oh, by the way, this is Nan Ze, who was a famous concubine, you should know about her, and gives you a little bit of the backstory.
And actually, it's probably a lot less clunky than the way they tend to do in American biopics, which is to have lots of dialogue saying, you are the famous poet, aren't you? And yes,
yeah,
that is exactly who I am.
Yes,
and you must be the musician.
Yeah, it gets rid of all that exposition,
yeah,
and horribleness.
You presumably were going to see the film very aware of the context to it, in the sense that it's been said that Avatar has been whisked out of the cinemas in order to make place for it, that this is very much a propaganda film and so on and so forth. Did you get the impression that the audience you were with was seeing it in that context, or had they just seen, oh, Confucius, OK, let's go to the cinema, see what that's like?
Coming up is the Spring Festival, the Chinese New Year, and that's historically the biggest time for cinema audiences. And I think the reason why Avatar has been swept around is nothing to do with its political content. I think it's just so Confucius, which was a very expensive film, can have a clear run at the box office. A lot of people who I've spoke to are desperate to see Avatar, but also Confucius is such a huge figure in China. I think you'll find a lot of people, you know, a lot of patriotic people will definitely be wanting to see this film for that reason.
Interesting, isn't it? Because under Mao, Confucius was very much reviled because he was into harmony, he was into accepting the status quo in terms of class, for instance. Is this film part of some kind of official rehabilitation of Confucius, do you think?
Yeah, it's very interesting to see how he wasn't popular for a while, but now he's back. And the reason for that is, like, although he did talk about things that Mao probably wouldn't have agreed with, there's definitely a lot about him respecting authority and being very dedicated, the sort of loving one's parents above all else. I think at the moment when there is unrest and things like that, that's a universal idea that the Chinese authorities will actually quite like. But yeah, Confucius is definitely coming back in a big way.
Simon Fowler in Beijing. Confucius has just opened in mainland China and Hong Kong and goes on release in South Korea in February.